Thank you. This is a sponsored video, but I'm only getting paid to showcase the pedal. All opinions in this video are mine entirely. Hey everybody, hope you are doing good. This is the R1 from Walrus Audio. You know, it's been almost a year since the D1 came out in the same series, the Mako series. I have been thinking and guessing to myself what the next type of effect could be, and you just need to trust me on this because I guessed that it would be a reverb. And I was right. I think I covered most of the features in the actual demo, but the thing that stood out for me at first, that was the swell function. I think this one really works well. I've tried a few of these before, and there's always some sort of problems with them. This one, it actually feels like you're using a volume pedal or using the volume on your guitar, so that's a very nice feature. And another thing that I really like with this pedal is how you access certain parameters. Like, you with some pedals you have a secondary function of certain knobs. That is fine, but I often find it a bit hard and cumbersome to adjust those. Here is more like what you see is what you get. You switch here and then you use the same knob to adjust that parameter. I think that's a nice but simple feature on the R1. It has presets, so if you like that, you have it here on the R1. Myself, I'm not that into using presets. I don't know, I guess I'm just very old-fashioned when it comes to stuff like that, but it has presets, and it also has MIDI in and out. Same with that for me, basically. I'm not a huge fan of MIDI. Actually, let me rephrase, I don't use MIDI because I'm kind of intimidated by it. I really can't say that I'm not a fan of it because I haven't really used it that much. If you're into MIDI, you also have that on the R1. And you can adjust how wide or narrow you want the stereo image to be. And that is actually a secondary function of the tune knob and in the X position. So yeah. And of course, it just sounds beautiful in stereo. I'm starting to like that more and more. So that's definitely a feature that I really like. It would be really strange if they didn't put stereo in it. So what do I think of it? I think it sounds fantastic. The first mode that I tried was the spring. That's always the one that I like to try first because it might be one of the like simplest reverbs. I don't know, maybe it's not easy to make. Spring reverb, that's my favorite thing. I use spring reverb on my amp all the time, and that one sounded fantastic. And the other ones are of course sounding super nice as well, and you can adjust a lot of stuff. It's easy to just try different stuff with this pedal and make sort of your own sounds. That's probably the thing that I like the most about this pedal. You know, when everyone got the DL4 from Line 6 back when, it was of course very good, but you can recognize the sounds like this if you had the pedal, so it was really hard to make your own sounds with that one and with similar pedals to the DL4. But with stuff like this, you can sort of make your own reverb, and that's fantastic, I think. So to summarize, I think it's a great pedal. It has presets that I don't really care about, same with MIDI, but of course a lot of people will use those features. It's a high fidelity stereo reverb, so of course they should be on here. A lot of people will enjoy those features. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, give this video a like, and yeah, goodbye.